crush me, boys. And sure, that's to hold your noise and listen to poor Paddy's lamentation.
Beginning in 1801, what would eventually become the Republic of Ireland was part of the United Kingdom and ruled by the British Crown. The bloody groundwork of the Irish War of Independence was actually laid in 1916 during the Easter Rising. The bold Easter Proclamation, much like the American Declaration of Independence, declared a free Irish Republic, free of British control. The Easter Rising would end badly, however, with several key members either being jailed or executed by the British. It would be another 3 years before the Irish people would rise up against the British. January of 1919, a group of Irish Republican Army volunteers, under the leadership of Dan Breen, fired the first shot of the war when they killed two members of the British Royal Irish Constabulary, or RIC. Éamon de Valera, the elected president of the newly formed Irish Parliament, makes a bold declaration against the British, claiming that the elected government of the Irish is the only legitimate government in Ireland. In May of 1919, members of the Irish Parliament send a claim to the Paris Peace Conference, making Ireland's case for independence. Then in June, Éamon de Valera departs for the United States, hoping to gain official recognition of the Irish Republic from the U.S. government, and to secure the support of the American people and raise money for the IRA. On June 6, 1919, the United States Senate passes a resolution asking that a delegation appointed by the Irish Parliament be given a hearing at the Paris Peace Conference and expressing sympathy with the, quote, aspirations of the Irish people for a government of their own choice. In July of 1919, Michael Collins, who would become a key figure in the Irish struggle for independence, authorized his first assassination of a detective of the RIC. The assassination was carried out by Collins' elite unit known as the Squad. They were tasked with being the Irish answer to British intelligence during the war. Things reached a turning point in September of 1919, when the Dail, or Irish Parliament, was officially outlawed by the British. In March of 1920, the British paramilitary unit known as the Black and Tans arrived in Ireland. They would become notorious for their attacks on civilians, and burning houses, and their brutal tactics. Perhaps the most well-known and most infamous day of the Irish War of Independence came on November 21st, 1920. In the morning, 11 British Army officers were killed, and 5 more wounded by the IRA. In retaliation that afternoon, the British opened fire on a crowd of spectators and a football match, killing 14 innocent victims. That evening, 2 IRA prisoners were shot and killed as they were trying to escape from Dublin Castle, according to the British. Because of the high death toll, the day forever became known as Bloody Sunday. As 1920 drew to a close, British generals, led by Neville Macready, predicted they would have victory in Ireland by the spring. A key moment arrives on March 11th, 1921, when the Dail, after much debate, officially declared war on Britain. In May of that year, Pope Benedict XV wrote a letter encouraging peace between Britain and Ireland in a hopeful attempt to end the bloodshed. Things began to look up on July 9, 1921, as an armistice was signed in Dublin which would go into effect on July 11th, putting a at least temporary end to the hostilities. In October of 1921, the Irish delegation arrived in London to begin peace talks, hoping to finally, at long last, bring an end to the war. The peace talks would last until December, and then finally, on December 6th, 1921, the Anglo-Irish Treaty was signed in London, officially putting an end to the Irish War of Independence. After much debate, the Anglo-Irish Treaty was ratified by the Dáil on January 7, 1922. Then, on January 16th, under the terms of the treaty, Dublin Castle was surrendered to the Provisional Government. Almost a year after the British surrendered Dublin Castle, on December 6th, 1922, the Irish Free State was officially created. At long last, the Irish had obtained their independence, and though the cost was high. 11 days after the creation of the Irish Free State, on December 17th, 1922, the last remnants of the British forces withdrew from Ireland, leaving behind a bloody legacy.